Whether orchids are 12 million years old or 82 million years old. But about 10 years ago, scientists from Harvard, biologists, discovered pollen from a bee. There was evidence that orchids were 100 million years old. And I wonder what it's like to feel that old. Of years ago, from thousands of years ago, millions of years ago, what is passed on, and is that held within this unconscious, and do we remember it when we fall asleep at night? Do we remember it while we're walking and there's something that we recall? So, speaking of dreams, Carl Jung, he wrote about the hero's journey, of course, and this kind of searching, and the searching for something, and this something sometimes, well, I don't know if you've seen the movie with Nicolas Cage, and there's this part where this character, he is obsessed with finding orchids. And at one point, he's obsessed with finding fish, and then he stopped being interested in fish, and he said, I'm done with fish. I'm just done with fish, and he became interested in orchids. Mm-hmm. this particular orchid and how Darwin wrote about that there is an insect with a 6-inch nose that actually fits this orchid so it can pollinate it. Because these orchids, there are about 28,000 species of orchids, but we mostly only see one kind. But this particular kind, the ghost orchid. And in here he talks about, and I've actually had a dream about this after I saw this film, about how a lot of orchids don't produce nectar, and so they look like the insect that they want to pollinate them. And so he's talking about when you find your flower, keep your flower, but in this one, the bee actually has to fly around to different flowers, so I don't know if that analogy really fits. Maybe if you find multiple of this kind of flower and you make love to multiple kinds of flowers as this insect, you are helping to pollinate. Particular flower was the Cattleya orchid. And Cattleya, you'll sometimes see it, but the most well-known, well, there's a couple well-known. One of them is vanilla. So I thought I would get here. One second.
Preservatives, and I'm not sure what that's from. So you're welcome to have some. I'm going to pass it around. You can imagine it's like Proust Madeleine, and it can like bring back memories if you so like, or you can just enjoy it. Orchid delirium. And this happened where
people would go out to ships and they'd sail to these places because they had boats finally. And I mean a boat, but they were able to travel. And they'd go to these countries and they would take these flowers, and some of them would die in the mission. And they'd get, you know, dysentery, or they'd get malaria, or they'd be killed. And these flowers would sometimes go for what is the equivalent of about $20,000 now. However, when greenhouses came about, they were able to cultivate orchids, and this need for orchid finding these orchids in different places were no longer needed, so they no longer were precious. And orchid delirium finished. I mean, there's still sometimes people looking for them, but it's not the same kind of intensity as the 1800s. Orchids. I mean, it's winter now, and there should probably be just pictures of unbloomed orchids. But when I was a kid, my grandmother's house would be full of orchids. She loved them because her father was a well-known botanist from Japan and worked in Taiwan during the occupation, and he worked in Orchid Island and learning about orchids during this time. Actually, the cultivation of them, the creating of them, actually endangered many of them, because when people would find that exotic thing they were searching for, in order to stop competition, they would destroy the environment. They'd burn down the different places that they found these rare orchids, so no one else could find these rare orchids. And the trips were funded by the same things that were destroying these environments: industrialization, the railroads. Same thing that built these conservations were the things destroying the things that they sought to conserve. orchid, a lot of people have these kind of romantic or sexual connotations, right? And orchid actually means testicle in Greek, because their bulbs look like testicles. And it was thought that during the Aztec times, there are different cultures that if you eat or somehow use these parts of orchids, it will help with fertility or impotence, or was an aphrodisiac. So it has this kind of allure to it.
Back there and forward time.
the stars again. The stars again, again, again. The stars again. The stars again. The stars again. The stars again. Different kinds of orchids, but the kind that you most likely know, Phalaenopsis. This is the Phalaenopsis. And the Phalaenopsis is what, if you have an orchid, you probably have this kind. It's the kind you can get at Trader Joe's, at Costco. And most people, because it's the only kind that seems to last, is a kind seems to still be here. So I hope that tonight when you're dreaming, you dream of many kinds of flowers. The kinds that you don't see, ones that you've never seen, ones that don't exist, but maybe do exist. Good night.